Often when a baby is born to a Chinese family, a confinement nanny is hired to care for it for the first month, or what is known as a confinement period. The practice of confinement nannies has spawned an industry around the business of birthing. The business is especially lucrative in the San Gabriel Valley. I visited one Chinese confinement nanny in Monterey Park to find out more about her occupation. Beyond confinement nannies, meal services and consultancies have found a foothold in the growing postpartum care market.
Usually it will be cooked by the elder women. Nowadays we're like small families, only couples and their newborn baby. So they may need some services. They may hire some nannies to cook for them, or they can hire some catering services such as us. So we will design a series of menus. Besides the regular meals, we cook with the herbs. And the herbs will be like tonify your energy, tonify your blood. Right now we have Hong Kong people, Taiwan people. We also have like Vietnamese, Malaysians, and even like Japanese ordering our meals.
My Asian Nanny is an example of an agency that connects families with a confinement nanny.
For example, 1 month confinement nanny, it's about 4,500 to 6,000. So it is a lot of money, but there's no set income level on my client. Right now the Chinese nanny is very popular because of Trump. I guess his daughter Ivanka has like Chinese nanny and they learn Chinese.
Wealthy American families are also hiring Chinese nannies to teach their children language skills. New immigrants and Asian Americans make up the vital consumer base of confinement nannies. However, the relationship between clients and nannies are often much more than business partnerships.
他上个月全家来美国旅行，还请我吃饭，还请了部车，一直在到处的旅游，还找我去。我们是好朋友了。他说，baby给我带饭，在美国都放心，很放心。我们都是挺好挺好的朋友。
Though it is uncertain that the practice will widely spread to American homes in the near future, it proves to be a vital aspect of the Chinese-American community.